Helen's training prior to law school at Mitchell was as a social worker. And it's clear that in her work as a lawyer and as a judge, she brought that multidisciplinary, well-rounded understanding of the human condition to her work.
I think it's really her personal qualities. She's a genuinely kind person, a compassionate person, and also passionate. And I think those qualities all served her well as a lawyer, as a mediator, and on the Supreme Court.
And in our conferences, she listened, but clearly had a sense of where she thought the law was and how it applied to a given set of facts.
She truly cared about her clients. She expressed that care, that respect, not only for her clients, but for everybody in the litigation system.
I think also as a Supreme Court justice, it was important for her to understand and measure the impact that court decisions would have on regular Minnesotans.
Having people like Helen who understand that what we do is not about us as justices, that it's about getting it right in terms of our interpretation of the law and our application of the law to a given set of facts.
Her technical expertise was well known. She knew the law at a highly technical level.
Her intellect, her ability to dissect the problem.
In all of her activities, Helen always does her homework. She listens carefully. She asks the right questions. She deliberates collaboratively, and she uses great judgment.
And I won't tell any stories about the time she's led the court in song.
She helped the legal system pay attention to the vulnerable folks, people with mental illness, chemical dependency, parents who are in the child protection system.
I'm really privileged to know Helen Meyer and to have worked with her for a long time. She's a remarkable success story from that dairy farm in Stearns County to the Minnesota Supreme Court.
That, I think, is in large measure what is going to be the legacy of Helen Meyer on the legal system.